In the last exciting installment, we fell down a pit to level 5. But we're not quite ready to make it to... We're not quite ready to go to level 5 yet, so... We used our grappling hook and we climbed back up. And we're going to explore the rest of this level first. Need to create my weapons again. We went up a level in the last video, which is good. Means we now have cure serious wounds. Makes it a little easier on us. Oops. It would help if I used the right number pad. Or the right keys. Man, what a clusterfuck. I'm gonna take some damage from this one. What the heck was that? A death knight cannot be turned. However, this mattered little to me, for I am a mage. Yeah. Freaking mages. I think they're God's gift to dungeons. And I'm in a bad position. But that's okay. Good gravy. I am so glad I don't have to worry about food. I know I said that before. It's just a testament to how glad I am. And how glad is that? Extremely. Of course, it just comes with the territory of being a cleric. That's why it's the best class in this game. Another holy key, or a key of faith. I have one of those. I have a holy key too. Come down to Duke's Discount Key Warehouse. We've got keys to every door known to man. We've got keys to the city. Keys on a typewriter. We got more keys than we know what to do with. Well, this door won't open, but there doesn't appear to be a switch around here anywhere. Or a keyhole. So it must be one of those one-way doors that you can only unlock from one side. Whoa! And that would be a darkness trap, it looks like. It's pretty crazy. I don't think I've ever run into one of those in this game before. Luckily, there were no enemies in that area. I wonder if the trap would affect them too. My money's on no. Yeah, let's not go back that way. Let's go the safe way. And there are the stairs down. How much more of this dungeon do we have left to explore? Not much. The bottom left and the bottom right corners. Well, looks like I might have to go through the darkness again. Well, I don't have to, but doing so prevents me from going the long way. Oh, we kind of breezed through this level, didn't we? And we need a sun for that solar system. So let's look over here to the east. I swear I want to turn these sound effects off. It gives me the freaking heebie-jeebies. No, I won't turn them off. It's all part of the atmosphere, after all. Anyway, I kind of look at this game as a precursor to games like Doom. Well, not this game, because I think Doom actually predates this one. But, like, Eye of the Beholder, which used the same engine. I mean, it's not quite the same, you know, visceral experience. But, I mean, you can really get drawn into the game just because it's, you know, first person. You're viewing everything through the eyes of your guy. Okay, where haven't I been? Looks like the only way I need to go is that way. Well, damn, there was another way to go down there that I didn't really explore. Let's look over here first, and if all else fails, we'll go back to the southwest corner. Deal? Deal. Sounds like a plan. I need some more healing. Whoa! If I didn't cast that, I think that might have killed me. I think it might kill me anyway. Okay, time to rest. Alright. I was about to say something about something. I forget what, though. Oh, well. Hopefully it'll come to me. I might as well just not memorize Create Food and Water. There's no purpose. No point. It does it automatically when I rest. I'm sorry, not pray for them. Wizards memorize clerics pray. But it all comes from the same place, really. I don't know. I don't know what the mythology of D&D is. I mean, I know that there are deities that you can worship, and you get special bonuses or something. Oh, that looks like the star that we need. I think there may be zombies in my house wandering around now. Come on. Yeah, monsters definitely respawn. Because these guys are right in front of the entrance. I wonder if monsters are smart enough to go through, oh yeah, I dropped those here for a reason. So I wonder if monsters are smart enough to go through illusionary walls. That helm of stupidity again. I really don't know if wearing it would actually have a negative effect on my gameplay. I mean, like I said, I'm not a mage. I don't have to worry about, you know, having a high intelligence to memorize spells. All I really need to worry about is my wisdom. Whoa! That's a scary looking thing. That's very scary looking. That thing's gonna kill me. I need to run. Holy shit. What the hell was that? Oh, I wish it didn't take so long to recharge between spells. That was extremely scary. Holy shit. Must be behind that gargoyle, yeah. But we got him. And he gave us a birch wand, a staff, and a flail. Now we'll see if the wand does anything. First of all, I want to see what that monster was. A zill? Or a measle? It was one of those. I never heard of either one. And the wand doesn't appear to have any effect. Just as good. Damn you, sheet ghouls. You're everywhere. I hate having to run so much, but that's the way it is. Alright, running low on time. See you next time on Let's Play Dungeon Hack. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you guys later.